Again, welcome to ITE 314 Advanced Database System Student Activity Sheet Number 3. Okay, so now let's talk about the relational model. Alright, so for the lesson objectives, at the end of this session, you should be able to, number 1, familiarize oneself with the basic in dealing with tables, rows, and columns in databases. And learn how to identify database keys, understand the codes, rules, or of RDBMS. For the materials, we have your student activity sheet. Then for the reference, you can visit this site for your reference. Alright, so let's see the different the reference. Okay, so you can visit this site for the reference of this module. So for the productivity tip, try doing a picture walk before starting this module. Take a quick look at the captions, activities, pictures, etc. This is to give your brain an idea of what's coming. It's like watching a trailer of a movie. Doing this for a minute will help you your brain to organize your thoughts before studying. For the lesson preview, review, introduction, a wonderful day, everyone. Yesterday or last meeting, we have tackled the core database concept, which revealed the importance of database management system, or DBMS, in managing databases. For today's session, we will be dealing with relational model, which was described in database models. Below are the topics to be discussed in this module. Number 1, basic concept of RDBMS. 2, codes, 12 rule of RDBMS, then types of the database keys. So for the activity number 1, what I know, so in the left side of your table, on the table, so answer this one. Again, every or each answers here in what I know are valid and accepted. Then say what I learn later will be answered na later na lang. So question 1, what is your perspective about relational model? Okay, ano na siya ang imo perspective? Number 2, how do relational databases works? 3, what advantages or advantage can we get by using relational database? So next, for the main lesson, for the content notes of our module, let's talk about the relational model. Now, what is relational model? Relational model, or RM, represents the database as a collection of relations. A relation is nothing but a table of values. Every row in the table represents a collection of related data values. These rows in the table denote a real-world entity of relationships. Okay. So relational model concept, attribute. Okay. Ano ba lang ginatawag natin yung attribute? Okay. Each column in a table, attributes are the properties which define a relation, such as student. Student. Role, number, I think, then name, etc. Okay, now, so let's go into deeper sense of this one. I have here with me the Excel type of document. Okay, here. Can you see? Magkita hindi. attribute. Sambalnya, for example, student ikaw. We have here TBL underscore student. Okay? So, sa TBL underscore student, okay? So, consider this one as a table. Okay? And then, I have here with me the record. Okay. So, for the record, okay? So, we have here the one. Siyempre, may counting, no? Okay. Next. Your ID number. Your, what you call, your complete name. Okay. You have here your email or Pinma UI email account. Section. Okay. Your level. And then we have here your section. Okay. Now, kung mag-ubra kita sa ano, sa table, okay, ari siya. Table student. So let's say ano nga lang yung ngalan? So I think I need to create a soft copy para sa aton nga sample. Wait lang. Para tanan maka participate. Okay. So ano ko lang. Editor. Copy paste. Okay, you can access this file by clicking this link. Okay, para tanan may participation. For example, here in my file, okay, none. Makita nyo, pwede nyo ma-access na. Pwede nyo na ma-access. Test mic. Pwede nyo ma-access.
Request access man, sir?
Request access?
Oo.
Bakit ganun? Wait lang. Ano gamit mo? Nga account? Hindi ka magamit sang hindi pinma-add? Okay. For example, aran na, naka-share na sa po. Share link. Naka ano na siya, naka ari na lang. Iniwan na lang, okay na. Ara na. Paki-re-access na lang. Makita ko dito 'no. Nan, may ari na dito oh. So halbuen na na. For example, paki-type ang inyo record dire. Ma-type niyo ang record. So, for example, si Salo na lang, example ko. Salo, ID number. Salo?
04.
Oh, 04.
Sir?
Oh. 04?
19.
19, 20. Dash.
19.
Oh, 19, 20.
20.
Dash.
04.
04.
04. 846.
846. Ah. Complete name.
46.
Name.
Salo Harlin.
Ah. Tapos complete name. Ah. Ano ni? Harlin.
Sa.
Ah. Nandun lang
Harlin Salo.
Salo. Ah. Ano ni gani? Butang tada po sample na lang bila Salo at for the educational for discussion only pinma8.com may UI pa na eh dot UI. Okay, next your level is IT 3 section D1-03 check to ko. This IT.
Sir.
Ah. So for example, this is now the record. Okay. No. I have here with me the record na. Okay. Now, ano brao natin drip sa record nga na. Okay. So for the traditional, this is our database. No? Mayroon kaya tawag nga row and column. So this is your row, your record. Okay. This is your column. Okay? Column. And so, gets nyo? So, ano brownie? So, this is a type of database. Ano gani ang ginambal nga database gani, ha? Salo? Ano gani ano gani butchilingon sa database? Wala ka pa?
Ay.
Ano ba ni Butchilingon?
Ano, sir?
Ano ganun Butchilingon sa database?
Is an organization. Is an organized collection. Organized collection, ano, sir? That typically stored in electronic format.
Electronic format. Okay. So, traditionally, amunin siyang ginatawag nila nga. Database. Okay? Now, magambal naman kita ya sa DBMS kaya na nato na okay magamit sa software. Okay, isa sa software na ginagamit dira for local hosting this one, SAMP. Okay, SAMP ang ginagamit. Now to access that, syempre makadto ka sa may local host at PHP my admin. Okay. Localhost PHP my admin. Nan. Sorry na siya. Okay? Makita niyo na. So nga ami mo ko na kaya nga nag-install ako sang SAMP. Okay? Paano ko ni makuha ang SAMP? What you need to do is to download the SAMP. Okay? This one for local host. Okay? So download niyo lang ni. Ngita ka mo for Windows dire, aring Windows. Okay, ang pinaka-latest ang muna piliyon mo, ang 8.09. So, PHP version 8 na. Api link, tapos SAMP for Windows. So, once you download that, okay, so all you need to do is to okay, run. Run the Apache and MySQL. Okay, once nga nakarun na, you can now access the PHP MyAdmin using this link. Okay. So, naka-install na nila yun sa inyo nga localhost. Alright. Now, what do I mean by this? Okay. So here in our module attributes, okay, Anong attributes ni student? Okay. Bisulingon sa mga attributes. Kung si Harlin Salo, ano ang pwede mo i-connect kay Harlin Salo nga mga details or data? Okay. Sa UI. Is it your record? Salo? Insakto ba lang ang data nga ni ang record nga ni nga imo ni siya? Sal? Harlin?
Yes, sir.
Imo ni, di ba? So, but silingon,
oh,
this
sir.
Is a type of your attributes. Okay? Yeah. Attributes mo ni kay imo ni siya ID number in school. Then, this is also your email address attributed sa imo. Okay? Also, this one, ano year level mo. So, but silingon, every fields yun eh, mga fields yun oh, attributed para sa imo. Okay? Gets nyo? So, meaning, record can consist of row of attributes. Okay. So, amo na siyang kinanamin niya, attributes. For example, magambal ka Rabia. Magambal ka Rabia. Si Rabia, anong pwede natin mayangot? Okay. Rabia is a Miss Universe finalist. Oh. Ano pagid? Taga Iloilo. Morena. So, busilingon, kung ano ang mga pwede mo i-describe kay Rabia, okay, in relation sa iya personality, so that's what we call attributes. Okay? Mga mga sample, Duterte. Mga mga Duterte, President, Philippines. So, mga mga, ang mga attributes siya, Philippines, President, lawyer, ako nun nung pagkita da, no? Then, now, let's go into tables, or table, or table. In the relational model, the relations are saved in the table format. It is stored along with its entities. A table has two properties, rows and column. Rows represent records and column represent attributes. Okay? So, anong ba niya? Ang aton niya table ko, no? Okay? So, column represents attributes. So, mga attributes siya. And then, the row, paigda, okay? Paigda, called records. Okay? So, I hope you understand. Now, tuple, okay, it is nothing but a single row of a table which contains a single record. For example, ma-describe nato ni, ang tanan niya ni is a records, okay? No, tanan ni, record niyo. Makita niyo ako nga ginano. So, record niyo sila tanan. Let's try this. Wait lang. Dito lang. Sige. Alright. So, tanan eh, records. Pero ang tawag natin sini nga isa ka record, ano tawag natin eh? Sino pwede maka-respond? Ano tawag natin sin eh? Ang isa ka record. Ha? Ang isa ka record niyo kay Salo.
Tuple.
Pero ang kabilugan sin eh, ano tawag?
Tuple, sir.
O, ang kabilugan, ano tawag?
Attributes.
Ha? Attributes?
Records.
Records na. So, record na tawagon. As being said, re.
Record, sir.
Ha? Good. Alright, so now, let's go into number 4. Relation schema. A relation schema represents the name of the relation with its attributes. So a relation schema represents the name of the relation with its attributes. For example, Ario, mga ano ni sila, mga columns or also known as your fields. So kada isa sini attributes na siya. So ang tawag muna sina sa ila, okay? We can also call that as a relation schema. A relation schema represents the name of the relation with its attributes. Aria. Okay? Ano ni siya? Attributes. Sang kada record. Okay? Ari lain-lain sila attributes, so oh. Email address. Okay, this one. Anong head? Okay? Ang tawag sini is the name. Oh, malaya. Is the name. The name of the relation with its attributes. Oh, may mga attributes siya, wala. Okay? So, meaning, ang isang column ni consists of different attributes of the record. So, ang pinaka-header yan eh, we can also call as a relation schema. Degree. The total of the number of attributes which in the relation is called the degree of the relation. Oh. So, malaka, it's only a term in our database DBMS. Okay? But, for your information, kung pila ang total number of attributes attribute which in the relation is called the degree of the relation. Hara, pila ka bilog ang aton nga attributes? 1 2 3 4 5. Pila ka bilog? For example, kaisalo only. Oh, kaisalo only ha. Okay, so ang attribute ni salo, siyempre ngalan niya. Ang ngalan niya na mo. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So ang balya, the total number of attributes which in the relation is called the degree. Okay, so degree na siya. So just a term for your information lang. So mga kailan yun mabalaan later on sa mga pag-apply nyo in real scenario, hindi ka mo ma-confuse. Okay, lalo na dire sa may pag-develop sa inyong system dire. Okay. Cardinality, total number of rows represent or present in the table. Oh, total number of rows. So pila ka bilog ang rows? Sa aton nga example. Oh, ari siya. Pila ka bilog ang aton nga rows? Could we consider this one as a tuple, a single record? Ba? So ma-consider nato na. So kung pila ka bilog na siya ang rows nga na. Oh, pwede naton ma-considered as a what we call
cardinality.
Yan. So tuple. Okay, considered as ari matawag naton nga row. Di maripatan na basi iban bala mo confuse. Ang tawag naton ni sa vertical column, ari row. Okay, di maripat. Tapos kumpila ang total sang row muna. Okay, ang tawag sina this one. Okay, the cardinality. Column. The column represents the set of values for a specific attributes. Ah, naman yung number na namin ko sa inyo. Column. Specific attributes. So, naka-specific siya. Ah, di ba? So, line-line sila. Okay, line-line sila. Hello. And then, it could be the same record or data. Okay, magamba ka the same data. So, tanan dere, pin ma UI email account. So, it should be dapat para reuse ni. Okay, dapat tanan dere, email. Wala ka din may makita nga 19, 15, tapos may ID red. Okay, wala. Line na niya. Line-line klase record na. So, but silingon, all similar attributes, okay, will be encoded here. Okay? Wala ka din may makita nga Harlin Salo. Kaya ang Harlin Salo na niya, iyan niya ang ngalan. Hindi niya email account. Ayan. So, but silingon, aton nga column, okay, the column represent the set of values for specific attribute. Relation instance. Relation instance is a finite set of tuples in the RDBMS system. Relation instances never have duplicate tuples. O, anong ba niya? O. Again, relation instance. Relation instance is a finite set of tuples. Final set of tuples. Sari yung mga tuples nyo. Nan, mga tuples. So, pila ka bilog tanan? Tatlo. In the RDBMS system, relation instances never have duplicate tuples. So, is there any duplicate tuples? Okay, may ara wala. May ara wala. May ara. May pareyos nga tuples record. Test mic. May ara wala. Ara pa ka mo? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Na, are try ta kamo. Ano ko? Pakitaan ta kamo record, ano, example. Are. What will happen if the tuple will be duplicated? For example, if I search Salo student record, okay? If I search Salo, makita nyo yung result, Salo. Makita mong result? Makita hindi. Salo.
Makita, sir.
Makita. So, but siling on, yes, pag search ko Salo, damo-damo gagawa. Imuunta na lang bi, ay, ari na lang ah. Ay, damo-ari, damo ni siya para use mo, De La Cruz. O, De La Cruz. Ari, makita na to nga may mga De La Cruz dire, no? Pero line course. Okay, line course. Now, paano maging unique, okay, ang imo record sa isa ka database? Paano maging unique? Ari dire, paano maging unique? Okay? Paagi sa ID number. Gets nyo? Nga may ID number ka mo. Harlin. Nga may ID number. Para sa diin ang ID number ninyo. Nga may ID. Oh, anyone can ano, interact with me para nga ano, interactive. Para sa diin ang ID number. Hello. Oh, sino na din pwede? Interact. Pastrana. Hello, Pastrana. Sige, padayo, nandun na lang. Sige. Now, ari dire. Ang question ko
para sa identification, sir.
Identification.
To recognize the student, sir.
Nan.
Identification.
Oh, saan gin-search ko ang De La Cruz? Ano nagawa? Damo-damo record, di ba? Oh, damo-damo record gagawa, oh. Nan, De La Cruz. Pero kung mag-search ako, amo ni record din sang UI, yo, iya register. Pag-search ako, tanawa. Oh, pila ka bilog nagawa?
Isa lang.
Isa lang. Kaya mo lang gid na ang record ni Salo. Hindi pwede mag-duplicate. Kaya kung mag-duplicate na, it could hindi mapalo ang principle sang DBMS. So, amuna sa ang prinsipyo
DBMS.
Principle of DBMS. So, dapat may unique key. That's why ginatawag nga ID number. Kaya ang ginatawag nga ID is identification data. Okay? Identification ID. So, I hope you understand the purpose of your ID number. So, hindi pwedeng mag-duplicate na. Oh, sa inyo, siguro, sa relasyon, siguro, pwede na, duble-duble, no? Pwede rin, hindi. Sa inyo, Ben?
Pwede, sir.
Pwede, ma. Sa relasyon, pwede dua-dua. Dapat single lang.
Pwede. Pwede, sir, eh.
Pwede, eh. Basta may mag-disagree din sa imo. Pwede dua ka bilog, bigohon mo.
Hindi, sir, eh.
So, ari din,
pwede, gid, sir.
Now, Arya, example, lanta ka mo sa Facebook. Okay. Sa Facebook, okay, sample. Facebook. Now, ang sa Facebook, ni, may ara sa isang kinatawag na unique key, mana, for example, Tony Saitin yan, ara. Makita nyo na sa babaw, ara, oh. Tony Saitin yan. Okay. Readable only sa user na. Okay. Pero, may ara na sa isang ano, equivalent number. Okay. Facebook ID. Sorry. Book ID. Find my Facebook ID. Siya. Nan, ari. Nakita niyo na? Makita niyo hindi?
Ah, sir.
Nan, makita niyo na.
Makita, sir.
Mag-type ako sa Facebook. Okay. Facebook lang. Hindi. Yeah, direct sabi mo. Oh, direct siya. Pero kung mag-type ako, ara. Yan. Makita niyo niyo sa may babaw. Ano yung butang ko? Number. Okay, number, no? So facebook.com tapos number lang. Okay? Amuna sa ang Tony Saitin yan nga to equivalent ang Tony Saitin yan nga na ara. Pointer ko na nantawan ta kung din ko makadto. Din ko nagadto sa akong nga account because this number okay, this number okay amo na siya ang account niya, ID number sa Facebook. Gets nyo? Biskan maglain-lain pa ng ano, ang imong tunay city niya, ano na, o kung ano ba ang ngalan mo, basta nakaregister ako, account niya number as Ari. Okay? So, if you want to know this better, ara, pwede nyo ni Mano, sunod. Okay? Para makita nyo man kung ano yung account number. Okay? So, look up nyo lang. Okay? Facebook ID number. Facebook ID identifier. Okay. Nan. So, tanawin nyo da. Okay. So, para mabalaan nyo. Biskan maglain-lain pa ng Tony sa itinian ko, ngalan, lainon ko, username ko. Lain pa na. Simo lang nagyapon ng ano? Ang ID number ko, hindi na pwede maglain. Username lang ang maglain. Okay? Pero, same na nagyapon ng account niya. ID number. Pariyosin eh. Ga-update ka mo sa pangal, ga-update ka mo sa inyong tuwag siya na dire nag-update ka mo sa record nyo sa may dire, nag-update ka mo no, pero hindi na pwede maglain ninyo. Mag ano, hindi na pwede maglain, hindi ni pwede grab sang iban. Okay, hindi ni pwede delete. Okay, so that's why hindi pwede mag-duplicate ni ang kada tuple. There is no instances that the tuple is duplicated. Hindi pwede. Okay, so may unique key na siya. Most pwede man sa mag-duplicate. Okay, pwede na sa mag-duplicate inyo ang mga attributes, pero ang ID number hindi pwede. Gets nyo? So I hope you understand, no? So base may mag-eskwela, parehas ang ano, parehas ang pangalan, Harlyn Salo. Okay? Damo na na parehas yung mga pangalan sa may ano, sa may record, pero hindi pwede magparehas ang ID number. So that's why humble dire. Okay? Relation instance is a finite set of tuple. In the RDBMS system, relation instance never have duplicate tuples. Okay? Relation key. Every row has one, two or multiple attributes, which is called relation key. Again, every row has one, two or multiple attributes, which is called relation key. Ano ko number? Anyone? Oh. Dire, sa aton nga record. Pila kabilog ang attributes gani? Lima. Okay? Lima kabilog. So, kung multiple ang attributes, ano tawag? Magamba ka multiple, more than one or more than two. Okay, once nga mag multiple number of
relation key
attributes, thank you, tawag natin sina is relation key. So be particular because you will be using these terms in creating or developing a our database table on our server. So kung bagsala amo dira, basi mo confuse ka mo along the way. Now, attribute domain. Ano naman na siya? Every attribute has some predefined value and scope, which is known as attribute domain. So again, every attribute has some predefined value and scope, which is known as attribute domain. Are. predefined. So ang tawag natin sina is our attribute domain. So let's proceed this one. Ari, make sample. Makita hindi. Han.
Makita, sir.
Ari, example, primary key. So amo sa akin ang describe. Okay? Nga tuples could not be duplicated. Han. So ang primary key ang 1. Ang 1 considered as the ID. Okay? Domain should not null. Okay? At guru99.com status tuples or row total number of rows is cardinality. Okay? Then column and so on and so forth. Now, in our relational integrity constraints, relational integrity constraint is referred to condition which must be present for a valid relation. These integrity constraints are derived from the rules in the mini world that the database represents. There are many types of integrity constraints. Constraints on the relational database management system is mostly divided into three main categories. What are those? First, domain constraints. Two, key constraints. And three, referential integrity constraints. For the database case, keys are very important part of relational database model. These, they are used to establish and identify relationship between tables and to uniquely identify any record or row of data inside a table. So it's very important ang atong ginatawag nga database keys. Okay, take note niya amo gina pinakaimportante. A key can be a single attribute or a group of attributes where the combination may act as a key. Below are the database keys 1 to 6. Okay, una sa tanan, super key. 2, primary key. 3, candidate key. Alternate key. Composite key and foreign key. So, ang common yung ginagamit natin is, hari, abasahan, primary key, kagang foreign key. Later on, you will realize the purpose of these keys. CUDS rule or CUDS rule for relational DBMS. Oh. So proceed ta. EF Codd was a computer scientist who invented relational model for database management. Based on relational model, the relational database was created. Codd proposed 13 rules for popularly known as Codd's 12 rules to test DBMS concept against his relational model. The CUDS 12 rules are as follows. What are those mga rules nga na? So we have number 1, rule 0, okay? 2, rule number 1, information rule. 2, guaranteed access, rule number 3. Systematic treatment of null. 4. Active online catalog. Rule number 5. Powerful and well-structured language. 6. View updation rule. 7. So we have here relational level operation. 8. Physical data independence. 9. Logical data independence. 10. Integrity independence. 11. Distribution independence, and 12 non-subversion rule. So here sa dalom to talk about the CUDS rule, so maybe on the next module, okay, to discuss that further. Okay, some important key points here will be discussed. So for the activity 3, what I know chart part 2. So this section serves as your review and summary of what you have learned from today's session. Try to express how your work knowledge has changed by reviewing the questions in what I know chart from activity 1, and write your answers to the questions based on what you know in the third column of the chart. So so for the activity number 4, check for understanding. By the way, so for the activity number 3, sa babaw, there is no, what I learned. You can now answer the activity 3, what I learned. No? So to proceed for activity number 4, check for understanding just like a quiz. Okay, are you now ready to record the... Test mic, ara makabugyapon. Number 1. Oh. So number 1. Test mic, ara pa ka mo? Oh, number 1.
True or false? Yes, sir.
Number 1, you can think of a table as a persistent representation of a logical relation. True or false? You can think of a table as a persistent representation of a logical relation. True or false? Pwede ka bala makapanumdum? Okay. Isa ka table para maging persistent representation.
False.
Ha? False? Nga false. Nga false how? Answer. Anyone? Answer.
True, sir. Kaya hindi man false.
Persistent. Continuing firmly or... ano na siya? Pwede ka eh. Pwede ka maka... panumdum sa isa ka table. Magiging persistent representation of logical relation. Okay? So, pwede true. Tables within a database share common attributes that enables the tables to be linked together. Can or cannot? True or false? Tables within a database share common attributes. Could they share common attributes? True or false? Audrey?
False.
False to no blow? O common wala? Common hindi?
Common. Ganit. True gali, sir.
Ha?
True dun, sir.
So, common. Pareho sa inyo bala? Common. Pareho ka mo crush. Diba? Jericho Rosales? Crush niya? Crush niya si Jericho?
Sir?
Sinobi? Derek Ramsey? Or Gerald Anderson?
James Red.
James Red. Babe, hati jaya. Gusto yo. Mga...
James Red, sir.
May na din lustre na nasa. Subong si ano na? Si
Mumulat. Wala na sila, sir.
Wala na sila?
Wow, yun na sila. Mga pangalaya. Kay ano? Nadine.
Hindi na sila na din, ha?
Sabi na.
Why na? Dubay
na. Na ya. Abay ko nagbalikanay sila. Oh.
Friend lang sila, sir.
Ay nako. Walang forever daw ko no. Walang forever, nag-break. Number 3. What are the 3 main categories of relational integrity constraints? Ah, nasa na tatlo. Ah.
domain, key, referral, integrity constraints.
Very good, very good. Sino tingin niya na? Anong answer?
Pastrana.
Pastrana. Dumako kay Pastrana sa Inspiro ka, di ba?
Ah, sir.
And has a Shopee account?
No, sir. Teleflora. Teleflora.
Teleflora. Teleflora.
Flower support.
Flower support. Yeah. Very good. Number four. A blank is a set of permitted values for an attribute in table. True or false? True or false? An answer. Identify. A blank is a set of permitted values for an attribute in table. Oh, ari siya sa may ano kagin, no? Gets? Ano? Ano ni?
Domain.
Domain. Very good. So, for the activity 5, thinking about learning that has monitor your progress, mark on the table your place in the work tracker, which is simply a visual to help you track how much work you have accomplished and how much work there is left to do. Encircle the day which corresponds to your accomplished activity. So pakiano lang kung anong number 3 na, di ba? So let us about learning experience today. Please take some time to fill out the my learning tracker. Write your learning targets, learning experience for the session, and deliberately plan for the next session. So here sa dalom ang aton nga facts. Okay, frequently asked question. What is the difference between candidate key, primary key, and composite key? Na mo naman sa mga pamangkot niyo. Consideration might influence the choice of a primary key. Answer. Candidate is a minimal set of attributes. Minimal, sumagagmay lang a set of attributes that uniquely identifies instances of entity. Okay? Primary is selected candidate key. Composite is candidate consisting of more than one attribute. Again, composite is candidate consisting of more than one attribute. Ang composite, more than one. Ang candidate is minimal. Okay, so muna siya. Next, how is data in relational database system organized? Paano? Okay, so the relational model of the relational database separates logical data structures from physical storage structures, enabling database administrators to manage physical data storage without affecting access to that data as a logical structure. The distinction also applies to database operation. Logical operation allow an application to specify the content it needs, and physical operation determine how that data should be accessed, then carries out the task. Alright, so some more question in module number module number 3.